What's going on, everybody? This is Let Me Drop One For You. I had a, I guess a request, you could say, a lot of comments on my videos about how to do some of the controls in the paint shop. So this video is just going to be just a tutorial, I guess, of some of the controls. And, excuse me. What we're going to do first, I'm going to go from the very basic to some of the more advanced, I guess you can say. I don't know. But first off, obviously the camera, to move it, it's just the right stick. Move it around like so. And then, someone was asking how to zoom in. What you do, you click the left stick, like click it and hold it down, then slide it forward, and you zoom in. And if you keep the left stick clicked down, you move the right stick, and you can move and focus in on a certain spot, like that. That's basically all there is to that. And then obviously to get back to normal, just go like to your bumper, then back to the left side, and it resets. Okay, there was, I had a few, I was trying to remember what to do. Oh yeah. Also, people didn't know how I was highlighting them like this. And all it is the right trigger. You click it, and it'll highlight one. And obviously, hit it again to unhighlight it. Okay. If you hold down the right trigger and hit up on the D-pad, it'll select the first 150, I think, or something like that, or 100 layers you have. Obviously, this only has 21, so it's only going to go up to that. But if I had like 170 layers, I think it would jump to 150, something like that. Then if you hit the right trigger, right trigger again to unhighlight it, keep it held down, and hit down on the D-pad, it'll unhighlight all of them. So there's that. What else was okay? Like these flames here, I've got them a different color just because I was filling in here with these blocks, so I just wanted them different colors so I can see better. But let's say I want the blocks to be, or rather the flames to be white. Just highlight them all, and you got your right trigger held down this whole time, and you're just moving the cursor over the layers down here, and just hit A on any of them. You can go to that one and change the color, change it to white, and they're all going to be highlighted still. Or you can go down to this one and change the color. It's going to change it no matter what. Basically, if they're all highlighted and you click on a highlighted one to change the color, all the highlighted ones will be changed. So like these can be highlighted. Now hit this background and change it. It's not going to affect the highlighted ones because it's not highlighted. But if I highlight this one, now you can see we've got blue and white here. And say they're all highlighted, change color, and they'll say change it to black, then everything goes to black. Even the one that's a different color. So, but we're going to change this back to that blue color. Of course. I lost it, but okay, or no, there we go, I'll paste it down. But yeah, we're going to change these to white. And also, people had some questions about that clipboard in the top right of the screen. And what that is, it's your most recently used vinyl, whether it be 10 of them grouped up or just a single one. Like I just deleted, well here, I'll delete this blue square. Notice my clipboard changed to a blue square up there. And let's paste that back down. We'll take these three and we'll copy them. Oh, okay, here's another one people asked. To copy, you click and hold the left stick down and hit the X button. Now look at my clipboard at the top right. It just, well, those are hard to see in the clipboard. I'll change the color. And I'll, like again, click down the left stick, keep it held, and hit X. And you see in the clipboard, it now has those on the clipboard. And I can go to the front bumper if I wanted to and hit the Y button, and that inserts whatever is on your clipboard right down. So see, it moved these three here. And let's say you want 10 sets of the three, you just hit the Y button, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And you've got all of them down here. Now, once, these are all obviously in groups of three. Once you hit the Y button, the only ones that are still going to be grouped up are the ones you just recently put down. But let's say you've got, I'll change these to white, and let's group up all the flames together. Got them all grouped up, and let's copy them. Or no, didn't want to copy them. Doesn't matter. But we're going to have them all highlighted, and then go down to group them. And that makes 2 through 11, or whatever your numbers might be, whatever ones you clicked on, they'll be considered one layer. Well, not one layer, but they'll be... they're like stacked on the same panel. Like down here, when I say panel, I mean like where it says 1, 2 through 11, 12. I'm calling those the panels. They're going to be smushed onto one panel down there. So let's say we click our left stick and hold it and hit X to copy it. And we go to the top hood and we'll paste it down. Notice I pasted it 3 times and they're still grouped up in their individual sets. So like if you paste and copy and paste a selected group of stuff, that'll all stay grouped up, unlike if you just highlight them. So what was the other one we were going to do? Okay. We'll do like we'll do the, like, let's say these flames weren't here. What you do to copy them all over, hit new layer and go down to insert all from right to left, and then bada bing, you got them all. A lot of this stuff is pretty basic. I know some people are new and they don't understand some of the different ones. But let's see. Okay, let's do something like this. Let's group up all of our fill-ins. Group those. Let's say we wanted to put an outline. So we're going to click our left stick and hit X. And we're going to have the left stick held while we hit the X button. That's what copies it. You just click it once and hit X, it'll cut it. We don't want that. But, okay, we're going to hit X to copy it and paste it right on top of itself. And really, it's not on top of itself. But when we hit, like, okay, like 2 through 11, I'll hit. Actually, I'll show you. I'll change these to black. Now, we just copy those exact same flames, but in white. So when I hit Y, they still look black on the car because these white ones are 100% directly under the black ones. We offset them a little bit and you see them. So that's how that works. But we're going to move them. We're going to hit up once and then hit Y to stamp it. We're going to go right twice, stamp it, down two, stamp it, and left two, and stamp it. Actually, not stamp it, hit A. But what you can see here is there's our top layer. I'm going to change these to black. It's bugging me. Okay, so there's our top layer of flames. And we have a white outline. Now, let's say you wanted the outline to be multicolored. Select, like, 2 through 11, then go to 22 through 31. Or, like I said, it doesn't matter what the numbers are. But that's just what mine happened to be. I'll change the color to orange. And as you can see, we've got different colored outlines here. Now, that's just it's difficult to explain because if you think about it, this orange set I've got here is the very bottom, and it's peeking out just outside of these white ones. Those white ones are peeking out just outside of these orange ones, and these ones are peeking outside of that one, and all of them combined are just barely peeking out around the edges of these black ones that are the base. So really, when you make the outlines, you're putting complete flames under them. You're just making this edge of them peek around everywhere. So that's kind of how that's explained, I guess. But okay, something else. Let's say, here, I'll make it easy. I'll make these all different colors. Now, I'm not going to keep these colors, obviously. I'm just showing you this just for the heck of it. We'll make this one. We'll go pinky. Okay, now as you can see, our outlines are all kind of screwed up. We got orange, blue, yellow, and green, and purple outlines. Let's say we copy these ones and these ones, like we did before. Or actually, no, we copied these two. Or highlighted, rather. We highlight those. And let's say we accidentally hit X and delete them. And it's like, oh no, I don't want to do that. You do have them on your clipboard still. So what you do, you hit Y and stamp them down, but you'll notice they're not in the same order they were. Because when you delete something as a group, or when they're all highlighted, when you paste them down, they're not going to come back in the same order. They're going to go right under the one you're clicking on. See, like, we're highlighting the green flames, and we're going to stamp the ones we deleted down. The blue ones are now under the green one, as opposed to where they're supposed to be, which is between the two. Now, it's very easy to move them. You just delete them with the X button. Move over the, let's say, obviously we want in between these two. We want to be over the green but under the purple. So you highlight the one you wanted under, hit the Y button, and you got them right back where you were. So that's basically it. I hope I answered some of the questions. It's pretty easy stuff once you get the hang of it. It just requires time, I guess, and practice and all that fun stuff. But yeah, I think that's going to do it for this episode. Just a small tutorial. Oh, I guess I kind of have an announcement. I'm not going to make any more Horizon videos, mainly because the more I play that game, the more I dislike it. Nothing against Forza games, obviously. I'm a fan, but something about Horizon just it doesn't do it for me. So I'm just going to be playing Forza 4. So if you guys have like a Horizon request, I'll do what I can. Like, it may not be the same car or something, but basically, I'm just not going to use Horizon anymore. But yeah, I guess I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching, and you guys have a wonderful day.